Hi all, I am Shajitra, working as Assistant Professor in PG Department of Commerce, Government College, Malappuram. Welcome all to my class. Today, I am going to deal with the topic Tax Planning and Managerial Decisions, which is an important topic in Tax Planning and Management of 4th Semester MCom. Before getting into the topic, let me make you aware of why tax planning is an important factor in managerial decision making. As you all know that tax planning is the methods used by the taxpayer to reduce the burden of tax in a legal manner. It is an arrangement of financial activity to maximize the benefit, tax benefit, which can be done by making use of beneficial sections regarding rebates, exemptions, reliefs, etc., so as to minimize tax liability. And tax planning is the arrangement of one's affairs in such a manner that the tax planner may either reduce the incident of tax completely or reduce it to maximum possible extent as may be permissible within the framework of taxation. Let's see the importance of tax planning in managerial decisions. In an organization, there involves so many decisions regarding manufacturing, purchase, sales, administration, etc. Management or investment decisions are not based on tax factor only, but tax factor is an important factor because it should be considered while taking managerial decisions, because tax planning helps to reduce the burden of taxes and other costs. There are certain general considerations which are applicable in case of managerial decisions. First of all, we have to identify the expenses which are allowed as deduction. Not all expenses are not allowed to claim as deduction. Therefore, we have to identify the allowable expenses first. Then the year in which it is allowable. Then to what extent it is allowed and to what extent it can be carried forward to the coming years. Next, we should identify the expenditure. While tax planning, we want to see whether the expenditure is capital or revenue in nature, because there are certain exemptions for these two types of expenditure. The tax planner should consider the advantage arising out of minimizing expenditure, especially in the initial years of business, so that profits may be maximized and the assessee may be in a position to avail the various tax incentives like depreciation, tax holiday, etc. Tax planning in respect of make or buy decisions. The income tax law itself provides various methods of tax planning. Generally, these are provided under exemptions under section 10, deductions under section 80C to 80U, and rebates and reliefs. Now, I will tell you the law of income tax and implications of managerial decision making. Sometimes, an organization wants to take decisions whether a certain product should be manufactured by the factory itself or bought from an outside firm. Naturally, it is quite natural that every component or part of a product cannot be produced by the company itself. Manufacturing involves various types of cost, then energy, expertise, technology, etc. Here, the company can opt two types of decision. One is to manufacture the component by the company itself, and the other one is to purchase it from some outside agencies. Here, cost of manufacturing and cost of purchase should be considered. Manufacturing involves fixed and variable cost. Fixed cost is for plant, machinery, building, etc. And variable cost is the cost for labor, raw material, electricity, etc. Then, buying a product from outside agency involves buying cost and inventory cost. If we compare buying cost and inventory cost, then we can take a decision. Here, What we are doing is that comparison of manufacturing cost with the purchase cost, and this comparison shall determine which decision the company shall follow. If the cost involved in purchasing from outside market is higher, then the company might go in for house production. Then there are certain tax considerations which are helpful for taking a make or buy decision. The first one is to establishing a new unit. If the decision to manufacture a part or component involves setting up a separate industrial unit, then tax incentives available under section 10A, 32, 80IA and 80IB should be considered. Export. If make or buy decision is taken for exporting goods, then tax incentives available depends upon whether goods manufactured by the taxpayer himself are exported or goods manufactured by others are exported by the taxpayer. Then sale of plant and machinery. If buying is cheaper than manufacturing and the assessee decides to buy parts or components for a long period of time, he may like to sell the existing plant and machinery. In such cases, it may be liable to capital gain tax because selling of plant and machinery involves capital gain. Then depreciation. If the product which is produced or purchased is a capital asset, then its cost will not be allowed as deduction in computing the income, but depreciation is allowed as deduction. Expense on repair or replace a part. If the product is a consumable one, then the expenses related to raw material required to replace a worn out part at the time of repair is treated as revenue expenditure and deductible while computing the income. Now I am getting into a question. The question is, the estimated cost of producing 6,000 units of a component are direct material rupees 10 per unit and the total cost is 60,000, direct labor 8 and 48,000. Applied variable factory overhead 9 and 54,000, applied fixed factory overhead rupees 12 per unit and the total is 72,000. The total per unit cost is rupees 39 and the total cost is rupees 2,34,000. The same component can be purchased from the market at a price of rupees 29 per unit. If the component is purchased from market, 25% of the fixed factory overhead will be saved. Should the component be purchased from the market? This is the question. Here, we have to decide whether manufacture the product by the company itself or to purchase it from outside. For taking a decision whether to manufacture a product by the company itself or to produce or to purchase it from outside, what we are doing is that comparison of manufacturing cost with the purchase cost. Let me go for the solution. First of all, we have to identify or we have to calculate the marginal cost of manufacturing the product. Marginal cost means direct material cost plus direct labor cost plus variable overhead. The total is marginal cost. Therefore, we have to compute the marginal cost of manufacturing. Here, the direct material cost is rupees 10 per unit and the total rupees 60,000 because 6,000 units are produced. Then direct labor rupees 8 per unit and the total 48,000. Then variable overhead rupees 9 per unit and the total 9 into 6,000 54,000. Therefore the total relevant cost of manufacturing is 27 and the total cost is 27 into 6,000 that is 1,62,000. Let's identify the purchase cost. Cost of purchase is rupees 29 per unit is unit which is given in the question. Therefore, purchase price is rupees 29 into 6,000, 1,74,000 is the total. Here in the question, it is said that if we purchase the product from market, 25% of the fixed factory overhead will be saved. 25% of the fixed factory overhead means 25% of rupees 12. 12 into 25% rupees 3 per unit can be saved. Therefore, relevant fixed factory overhead rupees 3 per unit can be saved at a total cost of rupees 18,000. Therefore, the net cost of purchase is 29 minus 3, that is 26, and the total cost is 1,74,000 minus 18,000, 1,56,000. Now, we have to compare the total cost of purchase and total cost of manufacturing. Here, the total cost of purchase is rupees 26 and total cost of manufacturing is rupees 27 per unit. That means total cost of purchase is less than total cost of manufacturing by rupees 1, and we can say a total of rupees 6,000 while purchasing the product from outside market. Therefore, the product should be purchased from the outside market. That will be the better decision. Now, another question which is also deals with make or buy decision. P Limited requires a particular component. You are required to give a suggestion whether to purchase or produce that component. For producing the component, a new machinery is to be installed and its cost is rupees 20 lakh. The sale value of the machine after 5 years is rupees 4 lakh. If there is any loss on sale of machine, that is to be set off against short-term capital gain. The rate of depreciation is 15% and the rate of tax is 30%. The manufacturing cost is given below. First year rupees 28 lakh, second year rupees 32 lakh, third year 36 lakh, fourth year 40 lakh and fifth year 48 lakh. The cost incurred for purchasing the component is in the first year 40 lakh, second year 44 lakh, third year 48 lakh, fourth year 52 lakh and fifth year 60 lakh. This is the question. Here also we want to decide whether to make the product by the company itself or to purchase it from outside market. Here also what we are doing is that comparison of manufacturing cost with the purchase cost. Let's go for the solution. First of all, we have to calculate the production cost of the component. For identifying the production cost, we have to calculate depreciation and return down value of the component. Here depreciation percentage is 15%. Therefore, the first year's depreciation is rupees 3 lakh, that is the cost of the machinery is 20 lakh, 20 lakh into 15%. Therefore, depreciation is 3 lakh and the return down value is 17 lakh, that is 20 lakh cost of the machine or component by minus depreciation 3 lakh. Then the second year depreciation is 2,55,000, that is 17 lakh into 15% and the return down value is 14,45,000, that is 17 lakh minus 2,55,000. The third year depreciation is 2,16,750 and return down value 12,28,250. Fourth year depreciation 184,238 and return down value 10,44,012. Fifth year 1,56,602 is the depreciation and 8,87,410 is the return down value of the component. Therefore, we have to calculate the short term capital loss. Short term capital loss can be calculated by comparing the return down value of the component after 5 years or at the end of 5 years minus sale value of the component or sale value of the machine at the end of fifth year. Therefore, it is 8,84,410 minus 4 lakh. Therefore, the short term capital loss is 4,87,410. Then let's calculate the cost of the product. Cost of the product means manufacturing cost plus depreciation minus tax savings. So manufacturing cost is given in the question. The first year it is 28 lakh. First year's depreciation 3 lakh and the total cost is 28 lakh plus 3 lakh, 31 lakh. Tax saving is 30% of the total cost. That is 30% of 31 lakh, 9,30,000. Therefore, the net cost is 31 lakh minus 9,30,000, that is 21,70,000. In the second year, manufacturing cost is 32 lakh, depreciation 2,55,000, total cost 34,55,000, and tax savings 30% of 34,55,000, that is 10,36,500, and the net cost is 24,18,500. Then in the third year, manufacturing cost is 36 lakh, depreciation 2,16,750, total cost 38,16,750, tax savings 11,45,025, and the net cost is 26,71,725. In the fourth year, the manufacturing cost is 40 lakh, depreciation 184,238, total cost 41,84,238, tax savings 12,55,271, and the net cost is 29,28,967. In the fifth year, the manufacturing cost is 48 lakh, depreciation 156,602, total cost 49,56,602, tax savings 14,86,981, and the net cost is 34,69,621. Then we have to calculate the net cost of short term capital loss also. Short term capital loss 4,87,410. Tax savings 30% is 1,46,223, and the net cost is 3,41,187. The total net cost of manufacturing the product is 1,40,00,000. Then we have to calculate the cost of purchasing the component from outside. Here cost of purchase is given in the question, and the rate of tax is 30% is also given. The first year's cost of purchase is 40 lakh, then tax savings 40 lakh into 30% 12 lakh. So the net cost is 40 lakh minus 12 lakh, 28 lakh. Second year, cost of purchase 44 lakh, tax savings 13 lakh 20,000, and net cost 30 lakh 80,000. Third year, cost of purchase 48 lakh, tax saving 14 lakh 40,000, and net cost 33 lakh 60,000. Then fourth year, 52 lakh is the cost of purchase, tax saving 15,60,000, and net cost 36,40,000. Then fifth year, cost of purchase is 60 lakh, tax savings 18 lakh, and net cost is 60 lakh minus 18,42,000. The total net cost of purchasing the component from outside is 1,70,80,000. Then we have to take a decision on whether to manufacture the product by the company itself or to purchase it from outside market. For taking a decision, what we are doing is that comparison of total net cost of manufacturing with the total net cost of purchase. Here the total net cost of purchase is 1,70,80,000, and total net cost of manufacturing is 1,40,00,000. Therefore, cost of manufacturing is less than cost of purchase. Therefore, the company may purchase the, the company may manufacture the product in the by the company itself. That will be the better decision. Till this, I told you about the implications of tax planning in managerial decision making, like whether to manufacture a product by the company itself or to purchase it from outside market. As a conclusion, I want to tell you that tax planning is an important factor that should be considered while taking managerial decisions. It helps to take decisions regarding make or buy, lease or buy, then shutdown or continue, etc. For taking a make or buy decision, what we are doing is that comparing the marginal cost of manufacturing with the purchase cost, and select the option having the lowest cost. Thank you.